Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about the new ComfyUI updates which happen in October 2024. And for those of you who are new, and if you have the ComfyUI portable, you can go inside that folder, go inside update folder, and then double click on update_ComfyUI.bat. In case you have not updated your ComfyUI for a long time, then you can do update ComfyUI and Python dependencies. Now, in case you do not have the portable version, maybe you have Linux, Mac, or maybe you are running ComfyUI on cloud, then you may have the manager. So you can go inside the manager and then click on update ComfyUI. Of course, once the update is completed, you will need to restart ComfyUI. Now, for those of you who install ComfyUI manually, maybe by doing git clone, then you just need to go inside your ComfyUI folder in the terminal and then type in git pull. I'm sure you are already aware of how to do this one. Now, this video will be divided into two parts. We have the update for the ComfyUI interface itself, and then we have update for the ComfyUI core backend. Let's start with the ComfyUI core backend. Those are quite simple. Now, the new node that we have is for the alimama apply ControlNet inpainting. I've already made a video on this one. And right now, with this update, it is within the ComfyUI core now. So if you'd like to learn how to use it, what is the workflow, please check out that video. When it comes to workflow breaking update, there's only one that I found that may break some of the older workflows, and that includes the ControlNet. Now, previously, when you were searching for ControlNet, it will say Apply ControlNet, like you see here, and then it will also say Advanced Apply ControlNet. Now, with this update, we no longer have the Advanced Apply ControlNet. In fact, it is the Apply ControlNet, the old one, which got deprecated, and then the advanced one get combined into this node. This apply control net is actually the advanced apply control net now. You can see we have the positive and negative. In the old one, there was only the positive prompt. Now, additionally, there's also this input here for VAE. So regardless of whether your control net model will use a VAE or not, you will need to supply a VAE input. This field is mandatory. So those are the only two changes that you'll need to make. So if you still have that older version, just delete it, replace it with this one, put in your positive, negative control net. That's going to be the model, the image. That's pretty much the same as the previous one. And then put in VAE, which is addition. And then the negative conditioning output will go inside the case sampler as negative input. Now, additionally, when it comes to samplers, we have a new sampler. This is the CFG++. It's for the EULA and the EULA ancestral. So you can always experiment with that. I believe we also have it for the DPM below. So anything that says underscore CFG PP, you can experiment with it. By the way, if you are using the custom sampler, this one, it takes a sampler as an input. So you can actually use those new CFG++ sampler by just looking for it. So we have the sampler here for EULA. As you can see, it says sampler EULA CFG++, and then you can connect it with this sampler. Now, similarly for the scheduler here, there's the beta here that was added a while back. But now we have one more, which is called Laplace scheduler, and it's going to output a sigmas. You can take that, put it in your custom sampler, and then pass it to your workflow like this. Now, concerning the backend code, there were a few minor changes, a few improvements in code, especially for Flux and the control net part. So let's move on to the actual web UI, the front end interface. And as you can see, it's a little bit different from my previous video. Let's just start with the top bar where we have ComfyUI workflow edit. So Previously, we had the workflow as a dropdown. You could see all the different workflows. Now you can see it collapsed inside this menu here. And you can click on the workflow. It will give you the option to create a new workflow, open a new one. So this would be any saved workflow that you have on your disk. You can also browse templates. And as of right now, we only have 4 templates, but I'm guessing over time, they are going to add more templates. So for example, for image generation, it's going to open the default one. If we go browse templates again, we have image to image, 2-pass upscale, plus the flux Ishnell workflow. So if I click on it, you can see it loads that default workflow. Now what I'm hoping this one would become is that we have the different workflows here, plus we can also assign our own local directory as an input. This way it shows you the different workflows that you have, and maybe have a search bar at the top where you can search for either the template or any of the workflows that you have. That would be, I think, in my opinion, a good addition to this screen here. And then we have the usual, we have the save, save as, export, and export API. The export is what you will use in order to save it in your folder, local directory. Then the export API, if you're doing any kind of project, you need the actual code, then you can use that in order to basically communicate with ComfyUI from a backend. I have some videos on that if you'd like to check out the how to use the ComfyUI API. Now, when it comes to the save and save as, this will save it for this interface workflow, which is on the left side. So let's go to the left side, and this button here is the workflow page. So if I click on it, you can see it opens a panel, and right now the top one where it says open, you can see a little asterisk next to each of these names. Basically it tells me that I have a workflow open, but it's not saved yet. If I go to the top, I can click on save or save as. Save as means that I get to name it. Save will just use whatever name that I have here. Once I have it saved, it will go down to this browse button. Okay, so moving on, we have the edit button. This will be your undo, redo, clear the workflow, and then you can also look at the clip space. So if you have an image here, you right click and you say copy to clip space. You can manage your clip space from this button here. Now moving on to the right side, this one has not changed. We have the manager as usual. It is still the same manager. It works. So I don't see any reason as to why it should be changed. Then if you are running into memory issues, you can use these two buttons to basically unload the model. Then when you click on queue, it will reload that model. Then you have the share button. So this would be the same as the ComfyUI manager share button that we previously had. Now what changed is we used to have the queue button at the top. Now it's at the bottom, and you can see that it is a floating panel. You can move it anywhere you'd like to. You have the queue. If you click on that little drop-down icon, it will tell you when to auto-queue it. So you can auto-queue instantly or whenever there's a change. And then you have the batch count. This number here is how many times you want to run the workflow, basically. Now, next is to cancel the current workflow. It's not going to cancel the pending workflow. If you want to clear the pending one, you'll need to click on this square icon. And then you can refresh all the nodes by clicking on this refresh button here. Now let's move on to the bottom right side. They've added a few utility buttons, and these are mainly useful for laptop users. So there's a zoom in button. You can zoom in using this button. There's a zoom out button. Obviously, if you're on a laptop, you do not have the mouse scroll wheel, then you can use that to basically zoom in and zoom out. Now, the square one is to reset the view. It's going to reset the view based on this blue outline that you have here. So this blue outline is basically a rectangle. And if I click on it, it will zoom and make that rectangle as my main focus. Now, next is a really cool addition. It's basically an option to change between select mode and then a hand mode. So right now I'm under select mode. So if I click on the blank space and left click, I will be able to move my workflow. But if I click on a node and then move it, I'm basically moving that node. But if I toggle this button and change it to the hand, or in this case, pan mode, now I can click anywhere and then move through the workflow. So even if my cursor or my pointer is on top of a node, I will simply navigate the workflow and not move any of the individual node. Now, if you are in the select mode, you can press and hold the space bar. That will give you the hand so that you can pan around and navigate. This, I believe, it's similar to Photoshop. So I think they are trying to replicate the same shortcut here. Now, next, some people don't like to see these connections, the node connection. So once you have your workflow and let's say it's working, you can click on this visibility option. You can toggle it off and then it will just hide these links. Now, the connection is still there. You can click on the queue prompt. It will still work. It's just that you will not see it. And if you prefer that, you can have that button toggle on. Let's go back to that left side panel. In the queue panel at the top, this one is same as my previous video. If you have like different queues, it's going to show up here. And I'm going to add a couple of queues here. And the moment I click on queue, you can see that it shows here as the pending job. Once I have an image, it's going to update here on the left side, the queue panel. So you can see the individual images here. Next thing we have is the node library. Same thing as the previous video, it is still the same. So I'm going to move on to model library. I think this one is new, it was not in the previous video. So you can see right now it's going to give you a visual representation of your models folder inside of ComfyUI. So I can go inside of checkpoint, I have different checkpoint here. I can click on a model, drag it on top of my workflow, release, and we will automatically select the correct node for this model. So I don't have to remember which load node to use in order to basically load that particular checkpoint. Now, unfortunately, as of right now, it's not up to date to the point that you can just go inside it, select any of the model, drag, and it will automatically select the node. For example, if I go down, I have some IP adapters. If I click on any of the IP adapter, drag out, you can see it does not do anything. So I'm guessing they are going to update this so that it can automatically select the correct node. But right now, what I found is checkpoints work. I believe LoRa as well do. And I think that's it. Most of the ones that I've tested, they do not work right now. Now we've already seen the workflow panel. The only thing that they've added is this browse examples at the top. So it's the same page. You can get it from either the drop down here or from the panel itself. So clicking on this button here. Inside the settings page, they've added this key binding where you can go ahead and customize the different key bindings for your ComfyUI. So for example, let's say here, I have the ComfyUI.save workflow and I would like to assign a shortcut to it. I can click on the edit button, press in the shortcut. So I'm going to maybe change it to Control Shift and S, click on save. And this is going to be the ComfyUI.save workflows as. So let's go back. It's basically this save as that we have here. And you can see it shows me here that Control plus Shift plus S has been assigned to save as now. Of course, you can change the other one as well. So I think that's all. Let me check I believe there is a LoRa merge or save. Yes, so this one is for testing. You can see it's a new node which allows you to save your merges. So if you're merging a LoRa and a checkpoint, you can use this LoRa save to basically save that LoRa now. All right, so that is it for today. Hopefully this particular update was not so frustrating as the previous one. There was only one thing. It's only that Apply ControlNet that may break some older workflows, but it's an easy fix. You just need to remove it and replace it with this new one. Plug in the VAE and then make sure that the negative conditioning is going somewhere. And that's all. All right, so thank you for watching until the very end. If you have not subscribed, subscribe. Let me know your thoughts for this update. Have a nice day, take care, and I will see you in the next one.